Welcome students, today is the fifth lecture. I am going to talk on GPS signal. As I had told you in the last class that GPS system consisting of the space segment, then your control segment and user segment, and we as a user are more interested in the user segment, but we do receive GPS signal from GPS satellites. And that signal is important for us, and we need to know more about that signal. So this class GPS signal has been coined. This class I will be discussing on, first I will introduce what is GPS signal. Of course I have already told something to you. Then the component of a GPS signal I will discuss, followed by summary, glossary and review questions. Now, as I already told you, user segment receives the broadcast signal that has been from the satellite vehicles, and these signals actually contains a wealth of information. Also these signals are a modulated signal which are having a number of components. Actually we need to know the defined components that the GPS signal contains, because most of the users do not make use all the components. Depending upon our purpose, also different users make use of different parts of the signal depending upon his or her need. So we need to know in detail about the GPS signal. Now the GPS signal fundamentally consists of three parts. If we start with carrier frequency, then it is the codes or PRN codes, which is also known as, and the data. Now actually we are, as a user, we are very much in need of the data that the GPS signal contains, but this data we do get from the GPS along with some code and in a carrier frequency. Now the basic reason is that why we take these two things also along with data. Actually the data that is available in the GPS signal contains a wealth of information which will be useful for our defined purposes. But when we will receive the data from some particular signal, we also need to know from which satellite it is coming. In order to get that identification, actually this data get modulated with the code. So code provides the identification of the satellites from which the data is being received. Now this code and data are in binary form and having very little energy, and as you know that the GPS signal is coming from satellite vehicles which are about 20,000 kilometers above the surface of the earth. So this data and code will get lost in the atmosphere, in the path along which it will coming. So in order to make this reach to user, it is modulated with a carrier frequency which is having very high energy content. So now these three together actually constitutes the GPS signal. Now to make the thing more understandable, we can compare this along with our if we take the example of some information is coming to you through from the postal service in an envelope. So the information or the suppose the interview letter, which is the most important part, is the equivalent to our data, and this interview letter has to reach you. So your address is required, and that is what is equivalent to your code of the GPS signal, and this together should come to you without any damage. So it is put inside an envelope. So and all these three will be the your mail. So similar to our GPS signal, the mail. So you can correlate this phenomena like this. So carrier frequency is fundamentally provide to reach the data safely to the user. Code provides the identification, of signal or the identification of the satellite vehicles from which it is coming, and it is the which is the information which we are looking for. Now this carrier frequency, actually in GPS signal there are more than one carrier frequencies. Actually the there are different types of carrier frequency available also for military purpose. There are some carrier frequencies, some data, some code which are specifically useful for the military purpose, which we will not like to discuss in this class. So we will like to go for civilian GPS signal. Now the for civilian use, actually there are three types of carrier frequency that is available in the inside the GPS signal, and these are known as L1. This is the short form of the name link 1. That means this is the first link that is being given between the satellite and the user when the system was developed, and it is having 1575.42 megahertz is frequency. Then next one more link has been used, that is called L2, link 2, but that was specifically for military purpose, and at present that has been converted to civilian signal, and that is termed as L2C signal, which is having actually this is 154F0, this is 120F0, where F0 is 10.23 megahertz. And subsequently another signal has been used or nowadays available, that is the L5 signal, that is having the frequency of 115F0. Now at present we will have three civilian signal or three civilian carrier frequency, and each of these carrier frequency has some advantages or strength. Like L1 signal, L1 frequency has a is the most powerful in the sense of it has very little ionospheric error. Actually, in case of GPS, when the signal is coming, ionosphere interfere maximum, and that provides the maximum error. But and the amount of ionospheric error will be minimum for L1 signal. So, L1 signal provides the best position among all the 3 free carrier frequency. Then L2C signal, actually this is a comparatively new signal which is available along with the GPS signal. This signal has very high power, as a result of which this L2C signal, we can get L2C signal under the tree also. So, whenever we will be need to carry out surveying under a tree or some very little cover, so we will like to go for L2C signal. Again, this L2-5, now this, if we make use of L1 and L2 together, then that will be better for our surveying work. Then the L5 signal, which is the coming up, still all the satellites are not providing L5 signal, but many of the satellites are providing. This L5 signal is very good for aerial navigation purpose. That means that aircraft navigation, we go for L5 signal. So, each one of these signals has some advantages which we make use for their own strength. Like here I have summarized that in combination of L1CA and L2C, L5 provides a highly robust service. That means if we take all these signals together, then that is a very good robust civilian use we can use. L1C has the lowest ionospheric error, as I told you, having the lowest ionospheric error. So, it provides us the best position. L2C has best cross correlation function performance. So, as a result of this, L2C signal will be available even under a canopy or tree, and L5 signal has the highest power, lies in ARNS, means aeronautical radio navigation service. So, L5 signal will be the best for our aircraft navigation purpose. And so, each of these signals has its own strength, and we can make use of these signals as our purpose or as per our need. Now, along with this carrier frequency, we also get code. Now, in case of GPS signal, there are 5 types of codes which are useful for civilian use. Now, the most important and fundamental code is CA code, that means course acquisition code, which is the one all GPS signal processing or GPS signal work has to be received or deciphered. Then we have and CA code is available with the L1 signal, L1 frequency. Then CM and CL, these are the 2 codes, civilian codes, civilian mid, medium civilian long code. These 2 codes are available with the L2C frequency. Now you can see here that the codes are related to some particular frequency. All codes are not available to all frequency, and then I5 and Q5 are the two codes which are available with the frequency L5. So, and all these codes has their one particular way how it is being designed, but one particular characteristics for all these codes are they are having very poor cross correlation and very good auto correlation. So this is the characteristics which all these codes bear, that they will have a very good correlation and very poor cross correlation, and for due to these characteristics actually these codes provide the identification of the satellite vehicles, and these codes are PRN, that means Pseudorandom Noise Code. If we see each of the signal, you will see that they are very random in nature. But if we see the full sequence of the code, we will find that this randomness of the signal repeats after certain interval of time. So because of this randomness nature, they are called pseudo random noise code, but this is also repeats after certain time. So that repetition means making it unique to each satellite. Now the one of the function, as I told you, of this code is to provide the identification of the satellites, identification of satellite vehicles. Another important function the code does is it provides the time. As you know, as I told you, GPS provides position, navigation and time, or PNT, time. So the GPS time we get from the PRN code. So the first approximate time we get from PRN code, and later this time is precise time we get from our carrier frequency, from carrier frequency. Anyway, so the codes are having two primary function. First one is that it provides the identification of the satellite vehicles from which the signal is coming to the receiver. Second function is that it provides the approximate time, means first time it gets. Now so with this I am not going much in detail about all this, you can go through yourself, and the but the most important part of this whole of GPS signal is the data part. Now as I told you that the data that is available with the GPS signal is modulated with the code, and you can see that there are different types of code with respect to different types of carrier. You have find that there are different types of code like CM, CL and then I5, Q5. Now each of these code will have the data which is fundamentally of same contents, but their formats are of different. So you have to be cautious in making use of the GPS signal, which will be having different types of codes, that is different types of data. Actually, depending upon the type, there are different like CNAV, LNAV, CNAV modified. These are the three formats of the data. CLNAV means legacy navigational data, civil navigational data, that means this is the modified form of CNAV data, and this type of data is available with the CA, this is with the CM, and this is with the I5. Anyway, so now this only represents some formats. Formats are different. So this is the thing we should remember, that the data associated with the particular code will have some particular format, and when we will make use of the particular code, we should be cautious about its the format. However, these data fundamentally, what really it contains, that is the most important thing. The most important thing about that, the GPS signal contains data which are basically, it contains the satellite vehicles, FMRS data. This is the most important information which we need to have from satellite signal. Now, what does it represent? FMRS data represents the some data which will provide us the location of the GPS satellite at an instant of time t. Suppose at an instant of time the satellite vehicle have at any time t, if the signal is coming from the satellite vehicle and reaching at some other time at the receiver. Now at that time, what was the location of the satellite? That we will be able to derive from the navigation data, from the data, and the which part of the, from the data, and the part of the data which is known as FMRS data, they will provide some parameters. Those parameters we can make use to find out the location of the satellite vehicle at an instant of time t, and that is the most important information out of whole GPS signal. Now second thing which is important and available with the GPS signal is the atmospheric correction parameters, then satellite vehicles, clock correction parameters, so like that you can see that satellite health, vehicle health data, information for authorized user. Of course, because as I told you, the GPS signal contains the military signal, so if someone want to use that military signal, they must have some authorized code or authorized information, and that they have to make use for using that signal, and that has to be correlated with the something with the GPS signal. Epoch of observation, when the GPS signal has been arrived. Time, I told you time, which we compute from the code part of the signal, later from the face part of the signal. So we can get time, then some other like user range accuracy index. This will provide the quality of the data, signal delay information, atmospheric correction terms, time conversion parameters, etc. So there are so many other informations available with the GPS signal data part, which we really looking for. So with this, I will like to conclude about the GPS signal. So the in summary, what we can say that GPS signal is the signal which we do receive or GPS user receive from GPS vehicles, and these signals are actually contents of a bundle of informations. Those bundles of informations are divided into three parts. One is that carrier frequency, then code, and then data. From the carrier frequency, actually we could not only it provides the protection of the data to come from the satellite to receiver, but also we can decipher the carrier frequency phase from the phase of its transmission to phase of its reception. We can measure the very precise time. So another use of carrier frequency is to measurement of precise time. And then there are different types of frequencies are there. For the civilian use, there are three types: L1, L2C, and L5. And apart from frequency, there will be codes. There are five types of codes for civilian use: the CA code with the L1 frequency, then CM and CL codes for with the L2C signal, and then I5 and Q5 codes with the L5 signals. These codes are primarily provides the identification of the satellite from which it is coming, because with each satellite these codes are unique. And the another function is that code provides us the time, which later we can make use with the carrier frequency to get the precise time. And the signal contains data. Data is again will be of different types depending upon the code from which with which it is being modulated. It may be NLAMP data or CNAP data or CNAP modified depending upon the type of formats, but fundamentally they contain the some primary information like the ephemeris of the GPS satellites, the clock correction parameters, the satellite vehicle health status, and many other things like that. So after this, I had given you some questions to you can solve yourself, review questions with this. And if you want to study more about this, you can refer to this book. Thank you very much.